In the name of God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. The heavens declare the glory of God. Let us worship and praise Him. Beloved, today we celebrate World International Women's Day, and that piece of music that you've heard by way of introduction, and that will be also the way we conclude this service, is by the composer Carl Jenkins. And it has its theme about the man who bears arms. And so we are mindful on Women's Day of all places of conflict and where women are bearing the brunt of the power play that is perpetuated by us as men. And so we are particularly mindful of the people of the Ukraine, where many are now at 1.7 number of refugees that have fled that country. And the men have been asked to remain behind, well, not even asked, but have been conscripted to remain behind, while the rest of the family, the women and the children, were able to cross the borders into the neighboring countries. The liturgy of the church today is silent on International Women's Day, but I think by now many of us would have been made aware. And so we commit the service, its intention, as we pray for peace in the Ukraine. And in so much as we are overtly aware of the plight of the Ukrainians, I pray that we will become even more so aware of the people of Gaza, the Palestine, the Jew, the Muslim, and the Christian caught up in horrendous conflict that has been predating what is happening in the Ukraine and will probably be unresolved when peace is finally effected between Russia and the Ukraine. And so, Lord, open our lips. Let us worship and let us glorify and praise God's name. And so I invite you to pray the Psalm 134. Come bless the Lord, all you servants of the Lord. You by night stand in the house of our God. Lift up your hands towards the holy place and bless the Lord. May the Lord bless you from Zion, the Lord who made heaven and earth. Let us, beloved, confess our sins. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, in penitence we confess that we have sinned against you through our own fault, in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have left undone. For the sake of your Son, Christ our Lord, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life to the glory of your name. Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and keep us in eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our reading today is from the Gospel according to St. Mark chapter 1, and I read from the 14th verse, concluding with the 28th verse. Mark chapter 1, beginning at the 14th verse. Now after John was arrested, Jesus came to Galilee, proclaiming the good news of God, and saying, "The time is fulfilled, and the kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe in the good news." As Jesus passed along the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and his brother Andrew casting a net into the sea, for they were fishermen. And Jesus said to them, "Follow me, and I will make you fish for people." And immediately they left their nets and followed him. And he went a little farther. He saw James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John, who were in their boat mending the nets. Immediately he called them, And they left their father Zebedee in the boat with the hired men and followed him. They came to Capernaum, and when the Sabbath came, he entered the synagogue and taught. They were astounded at his teaching, for he taught them as one having authority and not as the scribes. Just then there was in their synagogue a man with an unclean spirit, and he cried out, What have you to do with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us? I know who you are, the Holy One of God. But Jesus rebuked him, saying, Be silent and come out of him. And the unclean spirit, convulsing him and crying with a loud voice, came out of him. They were all amazed. And he kept on asking one another, What is this? A new teaching with authority. And he commands even the unclean spirits, and they obeyed him. And at once his fame began to spread throughout the surrounding region of Galilee. And because it's International Women's Day, I want to extend the reading to the following few verses, and hopefully it will become obvious why. As soon as they left the synagogue, they entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. Now Simon's mother-in-law was in bed with a fever, and they told him about her at once. He came and took her by the hand and lifted her up. And then the fever left her, and she began to serve them. Here ends the reading. So we see in the Gospel of John that he moves very swiftly. It begins with the proclamation from Isaiah, I am sending my messenger ahead of you. And then we have John the Baptizer appearing in the wilderness. And then Jesus is baptized. And from there on, the temptation. And then immediately after that, the baptism, the temptation in the desert. And then that quickly he calls people. And immediately they respond. Father Zebedee is left in the boat. I don't know if his boy is still consulted with him. There was some negotiation. What is most peculiar here, the two, Peter we know is a bit older. But these two young men, the father is dependent on them for his livelihood and for their livelihood. And so it is quite disruptive. The person that you depend upon most suddenly goes after a stranger that speaks with such conviction that they are so easily persuaded to follow him. And that seems to be the rhythm and the pace that Mark has. There's very little time for pausing, for holding back. And there is a certain urgency. And as we are in this season of COVID, and they say there's not so much ever going to be a post-COVID season, but it's how we adapt to it, how we learn to live. As for a long time, still wearing the mask and being COVID alert and sensitive to social distancing, that will be. Even on Sunday, I had to guard against seeing there were so many people, and I was very, on a few occasions, I end up shaking people's hands. And then what I really wanted to do was to hold, I didn't like this fist bumping thing. It looked so macho and aggressive. And just wanted to, instead of touching the arm, I wanted to hold onto the inner forearm, which I thought would be more friendly and more intimate and more welcoming. But even there, I did feel that one so easily can succumb to the joy of the gathering. And yet it is something that you and I, as we look back, not the 2 years that People often say, oh, 2 lost years. I think differently. I think it's been years of great learning, of great vulnerability, and a new way, a deepening of how we saw God present in the darkness, in the difficulties, and the strength that we saw in others and in ourselves that comes forth. And maybe in this instance, when we don't know, you know, when you're fishing, there's a lot of time your body is active, your hand, your vision, your anticipation, casting out. There's a lot of physicality, but there's also great moments of introspection that is the way of being out early morning in the open lake, as the wind comes up and the nature is also holding your attention. There's a lot of introspection that happens, and perhaps in that moment of recalibration in their lives, in their young lives, and in the lives of Peter, here comes this new news that has the old refrain of the prophet coming forth, and they respond, because where they are and were at a given moment that Jesus appears in their lives. And so likewise with us, where are we at this given moment? Is it just a resumption of church service, or is it a new way at looking at all things, at what we've taken for granted, and now again there's a resumption of the familiar, that which we've ached for and longed for? And it takes me to International Women's Day, on which the only time in this reading on International, there's a woman that is sick with fever. It's an illness that confines her to the bed, to the home. And that is the reality of so many women, that even so much as they are active in the economy, some of them are judges, some of them are chartered accountants, but they still come home to be mama. Those who are of childbearing age and had conceived and given birth to a child, they still have to breastfeed. They still have to provide often for their husbands and for whatever other children are. They have to be what is in the fever of life, still confining them to the domestic duty and to the rhythm. And this is what happens here. This woman is enabled to get out of bed. Women have been enabled by education and by a review of the gender role of women, and yet they are still confined to the domestic duty of the kitchen, because as much as she has been restored to health, still has to serve our Lord and our Master and his fellows who have joined them as he teaches them. She, known only by her relationship to Peter as his mum-in-law, his mother-in-law, and we don't hear resentment, but I wonder how Mama Petros, what she was thinking in her heart. Was she thinking, "Julle kan my aan die kooi gelaat bly het met my siekte as om gesond te wees en agter julle te kom kyk"? Couldn't you men have done the same and said, "Nee, mama, Rasma, take it easy. We will look after you. We'll bring you some broth. If it was Andelaide, we're bringing Chinese noodles." But yeah, we all stand accused by that, by this truth. And I wonder what Jesus would say today when he looks at his behavior and how he is recorded in history. As many of us who are men look at our history in relation to this text on International Women's Day. So let us say the song of Mary. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked with favor on his lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our forebears, to Abram and his children forever. Amen. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. And today in the worldwide Anglican Communion, we pray for the people of the Diocese of Kegezi in Uganda and for the bishop there, Bakamohunda, and in our own province, the Bishop of Pretoria, Alan Kanemeya, and in our own city, the Parish of Reconciliation in Manenberg, for Father Derek Clutie, and for the deacon there, Reverend Glenis Rhodes. And Lord, as we pray for Glenis and for Derek, we pray for the parish leadership, not only the wardens, but those in the youth, in the altar guild, in the brigade, the mothers' union, and whatever way the organizations are constituted in Manenberg, where they live and where they minister. We thank God for their witness, for their servant discipleship that they exercise. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of mercy, Jesus found a sure defense in your word. Strengthen us to persevere faithfully as we confront the temptation of life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We say the collect for peace. Peace for the Ukraine. Peace for Palestine. Peace for every place in God's world where there is no peace. Peace for women on this International Women's Day. Peace in the quality of their lives. Eternal God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works proceed, give your servants that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey your commandments, and that, free from the fear of our enemies, we may pass our time in rest and quietness through the merits of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Lighten our darkness, Lord, and by your great mercy defend us in all perils and dangers of the night, for the love of your only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. And so the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forever. Amen. So friends, before I bid you good night, just to remind you that on Wednesday of this week, we will have our book of Lent reading, The Women of Holy Week by Paula Gooda, and it will be in the link at 7 p.m., but we will be having a cup of tea and a sugar-free biscuit with a bit of almond in it, maybe, about 22. So please come and participate and join with us. If you are intending to attend, just for us to you know, provide adequately in terms of copies of the pages, we need to know how many people are coming, so just inform the office either by email or by telephone to say that you will be coming and provide us with your name and contact details. And so the hymn, the song that we will conclude with is the one that we introduced the service with by Carl Jenkins, A Man of Arms. It's a fairly lengthy piece, and listen as long as you can to it. The next 5 minutes is what we will, and it is available on YouTube if you want to listen to the rest of the album. So good night to everybody.